2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
All right, everybody, welcome. In this one, we're going to see the New Orleans Pelicans against the Boston Celtics. Well, for Boston, they look at this as a great chance to grab another road win. They know they're the better team and come into this matchup confident and ready to take care of business. And how about the rookie Zion Williamson? Unique in his combination of power and athleticism. Guys, who does he remind you of?
Close friend of ours. In terms of body type, just his has more muscle. The ability to get up the floor, just he gets up a little higher.
There's some Blake Griffin in him, too. You know, beyond the ability to score and rebound, he can also make plays for others, like the friend you mentioned.
Now the tip-off approaching. There we get it to Kevin Harlan, who's got the call.
And a glimpse inside the locker room. Players' final few moments to prepare for the game and the task ahead. The city of New Orleans, really a sight to see and a wonderful place to visit. We're happy to be here tonight. Hi, everyone. Time to get into it. NBA action on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And, of course, David Aldridge is joining us tonight from the sideline. And a chance to take a look at some numbers for Holiday.
His assist numbers in the past five games have gone in the wrong direction. He's been out of sync with his teammates, sort of playing on an island instead of as part of a five-man unit.
And with tip-off coming up, we've got just enough time to hear from our good friend David Aldridge on the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Guys, Celtics coach Brad Stevens is known for his play calling. LeBron James said he has so many different wrinkles. You've got to keep your head on a swivel. He'll run something you've never seen before. But Stevens said, honest to God, I've stolen everything we've ever done from somebody else. Kevin?
I love his honesty. All right, thank you, D.A. Don't let go of the rope in this one, Clark. Hold on tight, buckle in. A lot of pace, a lot of speed between these two teams.
No doubt about it, Kevin. And if you like popcorn, you better be able to eat it with your head up, because this one will be fast and furious.
Well, then you're talking about yourself, because our fans probably don't know this, but you're eating popcorn all the time during these games.
Hey, I love popcorn, and there's nothing like enjoying fresh popcorn in an arena. It doesn't get better than that.
I know.
Here we go.
And now the opening lineup for Boston. Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. Daniel Tice out there with Jason Tatum. And it's Walker in at the one spot. And for the Pelicans, Ball and Holiday combine at the guard spots. Zion is the four with Favors at the five. And it's Ingram in at the small forward position. Now Ingram following the miss by Kemba Walker from deep. There's the pass to Holiday. Down to five on the shot clock. Williamson doesn't go that time. Now the Celtics take it the other way. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
And guys, they walked into the arena with a certain kind of swagger. And we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
And you know, confidence is key there. They seem to play with a ton of it, especially on the offensive end.
And really an underrated playmaker. Williamson with good court vision and solid decision-making.
That's a two-pointer from Walker, and he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. Walker against Ball. On the wing, Holiday. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Holiday's got his second basket of the night.
Boy, Ball has a nice feel for when his guys are open. He's solid, really solid when it comes to getting his teammates clean looks.
Brown kicks to Hayward. And here's Walker outside. Drains it from beyond the arc. Walker's got five now.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Down low, here's Williamson.
Favors passes to Williamson. It's tipped. Hayward, left side. That gives them the lead.
Good read from Tatum that time. Saw the defense had overcommitted and then made them pay with the sweet dime. Well done.
New Orleans moving the ball around. Here's Favors. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. And the Celtics rebounding well this summer. From the loss of Kyrie Irving and Al Horford, Kemba Walker possibly a better fit for this team.
And with their young core, understandable that they didn't want to extend Horford out to age 37.
Shooting two.
A revamped roster, but I think they remain a contender in the East.
And that one misses. A whole new cast of characters for the Pelicans. Three promising first-round picks, Greg, and the young players acquired from the Lakers and veterans like Favors and Redick.
All of a sudden, a wealth of options for Alvin Gentry. Time will tell how they did in the AD trade, but seems like they're off to a nice start.
No good on the second free throw. Moves on moves. Greg, that's Jason Tatum.
I mean, this guy's a natural isolation score, jab steps, crossovers, turnarounds, fadeaways. He's got an awful lot in his bag.
The Celtics shooting their first free throws of the game.
And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for, around 80% on the season.
One of the things they've done, guys, is taken pride in their free throw shooting this season, and rightfully so.
Free throw good from Brown.
And the vertical that Brown has is quite impressive. As relentless a finisher that you'll find in this league.
And so he hits both. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Ball against Walker to stop the run. Nice step back to get it off.
You know what? The size ball possesses, guys, as a point guard is really a nice asset, especially when the defense tries to be physical.
Walker and the rejection by Favors. And they'll keep possession. Hayward finds Brown.
And when Zion blocks it, you feel it. He's got this kind of power behind these swats.
Holiday, and it's blocked by Brown, and he gets it back. Here's Favors, and three chances on that possession, but they just couldn't find a way to score. Knocked away. Tice passes to Brown. From deep, Walker. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Last meeting was in Boston, where they were unable to fight off the Celtics.
And they'll want to show that they're a much better team than they demonstrated last time out against these guys. At the very least, avoid another blowout.
And it really was the turnovers that fueled the blowout. I mean, a lot of questionable, poor decisions by them with the ball. And when that happens, you can get blasted.
Here is Hayward. Brandon Ingram picking up that last bucket.
Oh, reversed it home. That was pretty.
Agreed. The agility on display.
Yes, sir. Power and grace. That had it all.
Now, here's Ball. 9 points last game. And it's in there.
Yeah, another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here so far.
Here's Walker. He dishes it to Hayward. Down kicks to Hayward. Banked in off the glass. Hayward's got his second basket of the night.
And as a wing player, Hayward's just so good at attacking the basket. I think that's a big part of what makes him special. Doesn't take much of an opening for Hayward to make his move.
Basket counts. That's 7 points for Drew Holiday.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Holiday against Brown. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Let's check out the Eastern Conference standings now that we're in the new year. to take a look at the Celtics. They're fourth in the conference and looking to make a move the latter part of the season.
And I think for Boston, they've stayed right there, just in sniffing distance of the conference leaders. That's a solid accomplishment at this stage of the season.
You know, I thought maybe they'd have it in them to actually join those leaders this season. But you're right, it's still nice work considering where they are.
Clark, midseason rumors now in full session. When a player requests a trade, how strongly do you think that affects team chemistry?
You know, Kevin, I'm all for players voicing their choice and actually having an opportunity to express themselves. But it can be detrimental if a player in the middle of a season makes it known that he's not interested in being there. It can have a terrible effect on team chemistry, in my opinion.
So for the Pelicans, Hayes, he's checked in for Williamson. Josh Hart comes in for Brandon Ingram. And J.J. Redick is subbed in for Ball. And the Celtics also making a change. Smart's checked in. And so he makes both from the line. And so Holiday will bring it up for the Pelicans. Trailing by two. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Nuggets.
Yeah, I mean, they had their chances, competed deep into that game, but had a few lulls there that just kind of took them down.
And, you know, those are the kind of games that sting and that bad taste lingers. Knowing you were in it, but not coming through down the stretch, those are hard to get over sometimes.
And the Pelicans with possession here after the basket by Boston. Pass to Redick. Back to Holiday for three, and another three for New Orleans.
With deep range and a wide arsenal of moves, Holiday keeps defenders off balance.
Outside Tatum. And the layup's good off the glass.
Inside, outside, mid-range, doesn't make any difference. Tatum comfortable anywhere because this guy is a bucket getter.
Holiday against Walker. Holiday, the pass to Redick. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. It's a tie ball game.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooter.
Tatum drives in, and Derek Favors pulls it down.
That's exactly the look they wanted, guys. Right guy, right play, wrong result.
Redick passes to Favors. No luck that time on the shot that would have put them on top.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now. Boy, you've really got to put those away, especially against soft interior defense.
Walker's shot is off.
Well, I don't think he's performing up to his own expectations, but they still find themselves out in front.
Outside Favors. Back to Hart. Just five to shoot. Redick for three. That shot, no good. Now the Celtics take it the other way. Here's Tatum. Count the basket. Tatum's got his third basket of the night.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Now here's Redick. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Denver. Here's Hayes. A three-pointer, no good. Celtics leading by four. And Smart the bucket on the assist by Walker. Smart's got his second bucket of the night.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
And, you know, it doesn't matter how good your defense is on the perimeter if you're going to allow easy ones inside like that.
Now here is Holiday. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Denver.
And he also looked to attack at the defensive end of the floor. Three steals in that game. And pro move there. Finds a way to gain some separation against the much taller defender.
You know, your assumption would be that he'd be at a big disadvantage in that matchup. but you'd be assuming wrong.
So the Celtics called timeout. They're first.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
So both teams changing it up here. While there's a break in the action, here are the real stats, the real scores from the real NBA, revealing the top three-point shooters. J.J. Redick is second.
What a percentage that is for him from three-point range this season. His deep touch is about as good as you're going to see.
Here's Wanamaker. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game.
And that's his second foul already, and that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
Ball's checked in for Jrue Holiday. Outside, Smart. 52 seconds left here in the first quarter. Goes back up, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Taking a look at some numbers for Redick. How's the last month of basketball been for him? Sixth in three-point field goal percentage. And he's among the top 20 free throw shooters in the league. Doesn't waste many opportunities at the line.
And back to his efficiency from three. As you said, he's top 10 in the league. Defenses are now trying to deny him the basketball, but really to no avail. The first free throw is good. Well, the book, Greg, is the same for Enes Kanter as it's always been. Great score inside, but his defense leaves you wanting.
And, Kevin, at this point, he is who he is. I mean, for better or worse. Kanter is still a force off the bench to give a team some post presence in their second unit, but not sure he'll ever be a player to build around. And doing a good job getting to the line and capitalizing.
Exactly. I mean, that's what's helped them build this early lead.
Here's Ball. The shot, no good. Excellent D from Kanter. Tatum, that's for two. Again, the miss by the Celtics. Pelicans trail by six. Hart, the pass to Ball. There's 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Buries it from about 10 feet away. Ball's got his second bucket tonight.
And we've documented it. Ball has a hitch in his giddy-up on that shot. But it works. I mean, it's all about release and follow-through and confidence and repetition. And if he has room, then he'll make you pay.
Knocks it loose. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Smart. Redick with the three, and he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. It's the Celtics, up by four. From New Orleans, back in a moment. Gordon Hayward reunited with his college coach, Brad Stevens. He said they go way back.
Our relationship started when I was in high school. He came to my morning workouts and really recruited me at Butler and was kind of the first guy that I think believed in me that I could make it to the next level.
And I'm sure, Greg, that relationship played a big role in Hayward deciding to join the Boston Celtics.
And not just a connection, but a respect. Hayward now a veteran in this league, while Stevens has moved into the conversation for one of the better young coaches in our league.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And what do you guys think about Boston here in this one?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Yeah, and it's worked. They've got a clear edge and points in the paint. Now we'll see if they go with a more balanced attack or just keep on pounding it inside.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. Setting the floor now for the Pelicans. They're back, Ball and Redick. Then there's Jahlil Okafor, and it's Melly in at power forward.
Cannot let Tatum roll to the bucket, Kevin. When he's got a head of steam, he's going to finish with power.
Ball dishes to Okafor. Got a piece of it, and he's able to get it back. Smart with the ball. He averages more than 12 points a game. That's some dependable production. And a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for the Celtics.
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters. Actually, have gotten a lot of blocks as well, solidifying that defensive effort.
And also, how about the fact defensively they're getting that backboard and getting out in transition, especially in this first half.
Here's Wanamaker following the basket by Lonzo Ball. Now the feed to Tatum. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Tatum's got the lead up to 10 now for the Celtics.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
Redick surveying the D. Here's Melly. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Four on the shot clock. Offensive rebound.
Well, you've got to be there defensively. I mean, that's an easy mid-range jumper that he'll typically drain.
New Orleans has gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Here's Hart. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Denver.
And he also controlled the backboard as well. I mean, he really did a terrific job. And the EuroLeague's top scorer last season, Nicolò Melli, had turned down some NBA offers in the past, decides to make the leap to join the Pelicans and gives them a highly skilled player in that front court.
First free throw is good. All right, Clark, game is on the line. One free throw to make to win a big game. Who is up there for you?
I'd go with your colleague and mine.
Oh, yeah.
But since he's no longer in uniform today, I will go with Steph Curry and Malcolm Brogdon.
Great names. Ingram, he's checked in for the Pelicans. And the Celtics also making a change. Gordon Hayward's checked in for Jason Tatum. Clark, we hear a lot about the young basketball players in this country, the good ones playing in the AAU system. Is that the best way to develop talent for the NBA?
It's one of the better ways because the competition level is quite good across regions and throughout the country with these AAU teams. I think there's some great AAU programs and some tremendous benefits to participating in AAU basketball. Some things are better than others with it, but overall, I think it's pretty solid.
And Hayward gets it to go.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
And for all the drama surrounding Lonzo Ball's entrance into the NBA, one thing is for certain, he can play.
And Lonzo will always have the media attention, but the fact is he is a very talented player. His playmaking and passing was as elite as advertised from day one. Starting to find his spots on how he can score for himself, but everything else with his game is what you'd want from an elite point guard.
And that one misses. Well, it was only a short stay in L.A. for Lonzo Ball, traded this past summer as part of the Anthony Davis deal.
And getting out of L.A. might be the best thing for him. Still a great defender and playmaker. His best years, without a doubt, could be ahead of him here in New Orleans.
Here's Ball. After Gordon Hayward's bucket.
It's a plus-5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, over the last few years, there's been a lot of talk about seeding playoff teams 1 through 16, regardless of conference. Now, taking the top 16 teams is a tough sell, especially for owners whose teams are in the relatively weaker Eastern Conference. But taking 8 teams from each conference and then cross-seeding earlier than the finals is something that does seem possible down the road. The reward for fans might be a finals matchup with the 2 best teams in the league. Kevin?
Interesting ideas, David. Thank you. New Orleans shooting their 6th and 7th free throws in the game.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That one is off.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well. And we know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
And he sinks the second.
And already Okafor has become a dominant big man in the association. Has a good number of post moves to choose from, in addition to a nice jump hook.
Now, here's Cantor. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. They swipe it. And New Orleans pushing it up now. And finished off by Williamson.
You know, Hart so good at jumping into the passing lanes, taking risks at the right time, and coming up with steals.
And here's Cantor. Back to Wanamaker. That's tipped. Stolen by Ball. Feeds it to Williamson. And the dunk by Williamson.
And the defense learned a valuable lesson there. Don't let Williamson get to that launching pad around the rim.
Here's Wanamaker. Hayward outside. Back to Wanamaker. Lock at 6. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over.
And checking out the numbers for Ingram. He's been fantastic over the last 10 games or so, averaging about 26 points per, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds. Well, you know that he can put points up in a hurry, and he leads this team in scoring.
Yeah, you know, I think he's got a great sense of how to keep their offense going and being productive. If somebody else is having an off night, then he kind of steps in and fills the gap.
Hayes, he's checked in for New Orleans. Holiday comes in for Ball. Brown, he's checked in for Boston. Holiday, it's hauled in by Brown. Brown's got rebound number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Well, they're working the glass, really battling in that area of the game, and that's helped them stake this lead.
And Clark, when you were playing, I imagine the pre-draft process was a lot different than it is today.
No doubt about it. I mean, I came out in 1982 after my junior year, Kevin, and at that time, if you were a guy who was declaring early, you basically just had to go on whatever knowledge and information you could get from whoever, because there was no allowing you. You weren't allowed to go to a workout. Teams could interview you, but there were no on-court workouts, so it was totally different than today.
Out of bounds, Pelicans ball as New Orleans keeps possession.
Great instincts from him to get a hand on that pass and tip it out.
And, you know, even though they didn't come up with the steal, that's still a nice defensive play.
Daniel Tice is checked in for the Celtics. Now here's Ingram. He's coming off a 13-point game against Denver.
Yeah, but he was the ultimate two-way player. Defensively, also doing a great job. Couple blocks in that game as well.
Walker taking his time here. Brown finds Hayward. Over Williamson. Hayward can't hit. And so it's Ingram who brings up the ball for the New Orleans Pelicans. It's a 10-point game.
They can look forward to the Cavaliers after this game in a matchup against Cleveland. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. Outside Holiday.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
That three off the mark.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and rough. But that's how you win games.
And here's Holiday. Kemba Walker hitting his three to go. Hayes trying to break through. The shot by Holiday, no good. To the middle. Here's Tice. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And, you know, Hayward's floor recognition and composure, really impressive. Knows precisely when to pass over to the open man.
Now here is Holiday. 12 points for him. Williamson rejected by Walker, and he recovers it. Count it, good. Williamson's got 6 points in the quarter.
Yep, you know, after a scoreless first period, he's really turned it up a notch, building some momentum.
From deep, Walker. Pelicans with the rebound. Ingram's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Pass to Holiday. Back to Ingram. They get a hand on it and taken away by Brown. Out of bounds, New Orleans will take possession. New Orleans making a switch here. Redick is checked in. And the Celtics also making a change. Tatum's checked in.
Holiday, Holiday, Holiday.
Pelicans trail by 13. Holiday finds Redick.
Watch the screen. Screen, screen, screen.
Back to Holiday. 6 on the shot clock. Shoots, and the Pelicans miss again.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. I tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
And it's blocked. Ingram against Walker. Cloaked loose, stolen by Walker. And that's basket number 4. He's taken 9 shots to this point.
You know, he started slow, but now in the second quarter, he's finding his groove.
Walker against Holiday.
Come get it, come get it.
And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. Kemba Walker picks one up.
It definitely has the respect of the locker room. Holiday is someone that players enjoy playing with.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good from Holiday. There's 49 seconds left in the first half of basketball. And Walker kicks to Brown. For 3, Hayward. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Now Holiday shoots over Walker. That one a little long.
So hard, actually impossible to cut into the lead when you have a guy struggling this badly.
Tatum on the wing. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds.
Now, there's an example of good defense beating good offense.
Ingram passes to Holiday. From deep. And the last second attempt does not go in for him. And so it's Boston looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. And we'll see if they can keep up their tremendous shooting. They've been dialed in so far from the field. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Coach, you're in a good position here at the break. What do you tell your team to make sure they don't let up?
Well, I don't think it's about letting up or playing better. It's just playing the right way. We just have to play good basketball. And we talked about it before the game. That's our goal going into the game. That doesn't change no matter what the score is. So that'll be the discussion at halftime.
Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings to each and every one of you watching at this very moment. I'm Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is here. Shaq is here. One half is behind us. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Boston found themselves in a close game in the first. The biggest lead they were able to get out to during the first period was 6 points. The second quarter got a lot more exciting for them as they were putting up big numbers and find themselves way out in front here at the half. Taking a look at the Celtics, Shaq, what do you think?
You know what, Ernie? I got to stand up on this one. I salute to their bench. Man, once the starters came out, man, the others just came to life. You got to love seeing that kind of contribution come from the others. Man, they look beautiful tonight.
Kenny, let's get your opinion on New Orleans.
Well, I think their problem is rebounding, Ernie. You know, when you're trying to come back in a game, every possession counts because each possession can turn into points and you need to cut that deficit quickly.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. One of the stories here, Drew Holiday getting it done today.
And even with the defense shading towards him on every trip down, he still finds a way to come up big.
Well, we're not surprised by that. No more than what we've come to expect of him. He can adapt and adjust to anything a defense tries to throw at him.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. Trailing by 13. On the floor for Boston. Walker and Brown, they're manning the backcourt. Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. And it's Tice in at the center. Holiday. Again, Holiday missing. Boston's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Outside Tatum. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. They get Derek Favors.
Yeah, I like the aggressiveness of Jason Tatum there. He's looking for contact and doing a nice job drawing the fouls there.
Guys, you talk about players coming in and with a huge impact. Jason Tatum showed he was more than ready to be
Take
an NBA
break.
Star.
Take a break.
Where do you see a player as polished and as impactful as Tatum? Stepped right in to be one of the top players on a top team with Boston. Fits their system perfectly and really the sky is the limit for that young man.
Clark, we're seeing a lot of shooters drawing contact. They have that art form down. They know exactly what to do and how to position their bodies, don't they?
Yeah, they really do, Kevin. And I don't know if anybody's any better than James Harden, in part because he's so skilled with the ball, but he's a really thick, strong, agile guard, which makes him hard to defend without fouling him. And he's really developed that ability to seek contact in a legal manner. And I don't think anybody does it any better than him.
Now, here's Ball. Here's Williamson. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And how much fun is it to watch this kid? I call Zion Williamson a kid, even though he goes about 280, and he has a certain composure that really belies his years.
He's off on the first. And with Williamson, it's not just the obvious stuff that impresses you, Greg. It's the little things as well, the attention to detail.
You know, Kevin, one thing that stands out to me, every time I see this young man, the eye-hand coordination, whether it's on steals, deflections, block shots, he always seems to pick it cleanly.
And he's good on the second.
And maybe the most popular player to enter the league since social media became truly pervasive. Zion Williamson handles it with class. He really appreciates his teammates and his coaches and really respects the game.
Now, Williamson following the miss by Kemba Walker from deep. Ball kicks to Favors. Six to shoot. Here's Holiday. It's rebounded by Tice. Tice has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. And talking to stars in this league, even they want to see what Williamson's going to do next.
Sure. We talk about the leaping ability at his size, the handles, the shot making. But what really stands out when you watch him live, the instincts. Being at the right place at the right time and always seeming to make the right play.
Now here is Holiday. Jason Tatum missing his last shot. And the dunk by Williamson.
Yeah, he just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam.
I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will really start shrinking.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, one of the things that the NBA has been forward-thinking about is always accepting new ideas. They've got a bunch of them on the table in recent weeks. A mid-season tournament, a postseason play-in tournament, maybe even reducing the 82-game regular season schedule. Now, all of these would be very bold moves, but Commissioner Adam Silver has always demonstrated a willingness to think outside the box. Kevin?
PA, great assessment, good report. Thank you so much.
You talk about players that have transformed their bodies in the NBA. How about Gordon Hayward? Has added muscle every year while maintaining that speed and agility.
Shooting two.
Free throw good from Hayward. You know, Greg, when he came into the league, Hayward looked so young. You almost don't recognize him now.
I mean, the suit of armor from his time in the weight room and the hair looking sharp to match.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Williams, he's checked in for Daniel Tice. Marcus Smart comes in for Brown. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Walker.
You know, there's no question about it. Hayward is an exciting player and an athletic forward who can really, really score.
And Boston has possession. Here's Wanamaker. 5 points in the game. Now here's Hayward. Just 5 on the clock. And here's Tatum for 3. Gets that one to fall. That's his 6th field goal. He has shot the ball 12 times.
There it is. The first basket of the half after missing their first 3 attempts.
Ball dishes to Williamson. Outside Holiday. And another 3 for New Orleans.
And with that 3, his 2nd of the half, he's equaled his total from before the break.
Outside Tatum. Over Williamson. And there's the bucket from Tatum. Tatum's got 17.
And Tatum doesn't let the defense get to him. He's not distracted or bothered. He's got excellent form, stays with his mechanics. Doesn't matter who's defending him.
Here's Ball. Good for another field goal. Number 5 in the night. 5 for 10 shooting.
If you allow him to get that close, you deserve to get scored on.
Hayward outside. It's deflected.
In addition to being superb on offense, Ingram is also a ridiculously good defender. I mean, his long reach really allows him to come up with a good number of blocks.
And they pick up 2. Ball's got it back down to single digits for New Orleans. And it's Smart with the ball for the Boston Celtics. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. A shot by Hayward, wide open. No good from outside. For New Orleans, they've gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Boston leading by 8. pass to Wanamaker. Back to Hayward. Ingram with the steal. Here's Ball. And Ball slams it in.
How about that endless wingspan of Ingram? I mean, really causing the opposition a lot of problems.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
The second overall pick in 2016, a lot of expectations for Brandon Ingram. If anything, he puts that pressure on himself. This is a young man that wants to be great.
Both teams deciding to change it up. While we're on a short break, we've got some time to break down the Steelers at the shooting guard position over the last month. Marcus Smart on top.
You know, he's often forced to guard the opposition's top player on the perimeter, and still he's made his way all the way up the steals list.
I tell you what, I think he relishes those difficult assignments. I mean, he's such an intense competitor. Defense is what drives him.
Now, here's Cantor, and that one drops for him. Cantor's got six.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
Redick passes to Nelly, and it's good for two.
Important points there. Got him on a nice play, getting the ball inside and right to the bucket.
And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for Boston?
Their defense has been outstanding, closing out on shots and blocking a few as well.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
Here's Wanamaker. He has five. Tipped away. And there's the pass to Tatum. Pocket six. Out of bounds. New Orleans will take possession.
Here's where Boston sits right now, Kevin, in the current league rankings.
And you talk about their ranking in terms of opponents' points per game. They really stifle teams. I mean, they eliminate the easy runouts in transition, and they force you to play five on five and take difficult shots.
Here's Hart. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Outside, Redick. Here's Hart. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game. And a miss there on the triple.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
And for people who would like to see Smart take fewer threes, that mid-range J is a welcome sight.
Outside, Redick. Pass to Hart. ...18 feet out. He gets that one. Hart's got his first points of the night. And so Wanamaker will bring it up for Boston. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Ball's not loose. And a fast break now for the Pelicans. Redick's got the ball. Dishes it to Ball. Okafor against Williams. Passes to Nelly. Here's Hart, guarded by Tatum. apart. That's good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
Smart misses. Here's New Orleans. They're on a 16-6 run. Redick dishes the ball. Back to Redick. For the tie. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Redick.
A moment now to see the numbers for Smart. Over the last 10 games or so, he's really shown up. He's putting up about 14 points a night, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds. The contributions he's been making on the floor have been a boon for this team. Great stretch of games for him.
Yeah, you know, they've given him more responsibility, and he's responded. And the way he's going, I think his role is only going to increase.
A nice shot by Tatum.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of it.
Ball with it. 14 points for him. Redick finds Ball. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Ball's got 8 points in the quarter. Time called here, and the Celtics decide to talk it over.
And they've been very loose with the ball here. They haven't been as patient, forcing things a bit, which has led to turnovers. They need to just slow down and relax.
Hayes is checked in for Okafor. The Celtics also changing it up. Daniel Tice is checked in for Williams. Brown comes in for Jason Tatum. And Walker subbed in for Brad Wanamaker. Now, here's Cantor. He's got 6. Pass to Tice. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Tice has got 8 points.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use of the pick to get a great look.
Now the pass to Ball. Here's Melly, guarded by Walker. That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut down to just 2 points with the bucket from Melly.
Boy, he could have taken himself, but he went from good, better to best in getting the shot for his teammate.
Smart kicks to Brown. Here's Walker. Yes! And the foul. Lonzo Ball picks one up.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
For Boston, they have shot 10 of 11 at the line. Nice work so far for them. And the free throw, no good.
Well, one thing you've got to know about Kemba Walker is that this guy can go off at any time. A dynamic scorer that also possesses the killer instinct. And when he gets it going, watch out. It can snowball into a dominating performance.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
The battle to a standstill on the boards has really been something to watch, and the game's not over yet. We'll see if one of these teams maintains more energy than the other going down the stretch.
What a performance for Jason Tatum. He has been the story so far for Boston. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with him. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
Yeah, and as a two-guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it was really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. At the forward slots, Ingram and Melly. Holiday at the one and Redick at the two. And it's Hayes in at the five, down low. So that's the group out there for New Orleans. Shots good by Walker.
And I like that they're not settling. Getting the ball on the interior, eight of their last 10 coming that way.
Sometimes you just got to man up and take a tough foul in order to stop these free runs to the rim.
Now here's Hayes. And here's Holiday inside. Cut it, and the Celtic lead has been cut back down again to six with the basket from Hayes.
And you know he's finishing when he gets that close. Count it.
Outside, Walker pass to Smart. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint. Very rare for players to be elite defenders from the moment they set foot in the NBA, but that was the case for Marcus Smart. A tremendous physicality to go with a pit bull disposition has made him downright scary at times at that end of the floor.
Smart, no good on the free throw. You know, Greg, defense forgiven for Marcus Smart. The growth necessary for him has been at the offensive end.
And now, finally making progress as a three-point shooter. I had already made strides with his passing. He's becoming quite the two-way player.
Here's Tice following the score by New Orleans. And it's Brown missing. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Redick with it, now guarded by Smart. And a slam dunk by Favors.
How about that? Redick showing the same kind of accuracy on that pass as he has on his three-point shots, which is quite remarkable. That's how you drop a dime.
Now, here's Brown. Now, Tice kicks to Walker. Shot clock at five. That shot, no good. Great D that time from Favors. Great offensive performance they're putting on.
And guys, we call that the zone because that's where they are right now. They are in a zone, and I'm sure they feel unstoppable.
Austin leading by four. Moving it up. Smart misses. And here's Holiday, who will bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. Pull-up jumper, and right on target. Good. Holiday's got 10 points here in the second half. The Celtics have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Walker against Holiday. And that's good. Kemba Walker for three. And the Celtics lead by 5.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first 3 of the half, there might be more in store.
Here's Holiday. Here's Man.
He got fancy with that one.
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
And I like it, Kevin and Greg. I mean, some coaches might want to see just a sure-handed lay-in there, but for me, I don't mind a little extra.
Williamson is checked in for the Pelicans, and a change for the Celtics. Tatum's checked in. And that one falls for Favors. Boston's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Brown the pass to Tice. He kicks it to Walker. Offline with his three. The Pelicans have gone 5-8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. Holiday with it. He's picked up by Walker to tie it up. The shot by Holiday, no good. The Celtics have gone 3-7 from the floor in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. Walker's shot is off.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
And Drew Holiday, the bucket on the assist from Reddick. Reddick's got four assists in the game.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Holiday against Walker. Over Holiday. Walker missing again.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Here's Williamson, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
You know, his teammates calling him the slender man. Brandon Ingram, not much more than 200 LBs, but adding strength has been a focus.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. And with Brandon Ingram and his size, he could benefit from adding a few pounds.
Well, you know, his teammates call him Tiny Dog. Dog because of his determination. That's a positive thing. The tiny part in reference to his slight frame. Time to bulk it up, young fella. Weight room.
Both shots good from the stripe.
And the expectations for Williamson are sky high. A superb athlete whose skill set and drive to be great is off the charts.
Ingram with the steal. Passes it to Williamson. Ingram against Tatum. Ingram passes to Williamson. The kick out to Holiday. Down to five on the shot clock. From deep. They get it back. Here's Favors. Bucket is good. Favors has got the lead up to four now for the Pelicans.
Boy, you look at the defense, not nearly the hustle or energy at that end of the floor. It's the exact opposite of what it was in the first half.
Brown finds Tatum. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
Hey, good shot, Jason.
Brown's got assist number five here tonight.
Boy, I tell you, when Tatum puts it all together, he is so much fun to watch. He's a player with a very bright future.
Now here is Holiday. Williamson, another one falls for New Orleans.
Timeout.
And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
Yeah, I don't know if it's coincidence or not, but a much better half since they changed hoops. They're really looking strong here.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. One of the stories here, Drew Holiday getting it done today.
He can't miss from deep. The defense has to regroup here, and I think they've got to change things up because he's locked in from behind the arc. And now we get the chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Drew Holiday.
And guys, he's been about as close to perfection as you can be. The intensity he's played with has been amazing. Just no let up. And as fired up as he's been, he's never let his emotions get out of control.
And the Pelicans making a change here. Ball's checked in. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Brad Stevens had to say to his team. If this game's still up for grabs, he told his team, hey, we're in position to take this one, guys. Let's stay focused and stay together, and we'll get it done. We'll see how it plays out, Kevin.
Boston, no good that time either. Pelicans leading by three. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Kemba Walker picks one up.
An absolute beast. In close. Once Williamson has this kind of positioning, you pretty much have to foul.
And the first one drops. Both good from the line that time. Celtics trail by five. Now here's Walker.
And, you know, that's exactly what you want from your point guard. Get the ball to the open guy on time and on target.
Pass to Ingram. Outside Holiday. Shoots over Walker. Rebound Boston. Tatum's got rebound number five here tonight. And the pass to Walker. Over ball. Yep, it goes in, and the Pelican lead is cut down to just one on the basket from Walker.
You know, that's why Walker's the guy that really stirs the drink for them. Such a really good understanding of the pick and roll.
Ball, the bounce pass. Pass to Ingram. Point range, and there's Favors putting it right back in. Favors has got 9 points now in the quarter.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for New Orleans.
Boy, guys, I really like how they've driven the ball to the basket in this game. I mean, they've been very aggressive with it.
Yeah, but I also like the balance because they're doing a great job of getting inside and converting around the rim. I really like their aggressiveness.
And he can't get the first one. And the second free throw, good.
Yeah, being down 2 points instead of one, thanks to the free throw miss, makes getting a stop here absolutely critical.
Here's Holiday. It's rebounded by Tice. And so it's Walker with it, who brings it up for the Boston Celtics. Here's Tatum. It's good. This game is all even. Tatum's got 14 points here in the second half.
And Tatum, Kevin, has been in these situations before. He's reliable when it comes to stepping up in big moments.
Here's Holiday. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
Yeah, really left him no choice there, Greg. He had the foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
The first. So 1 for 2 that time at the stripe.
And you can sense that the pressure might have gotten to him a little bit, but he did do enough to put them in the lead.
New Orleans has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Williamson, kicks it to Ball. Ingram outside. New Orleans needs to get off a shot. Here's Williamson, and they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Boston's gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. Here's Walker. It's good, and they get the go-ahead bucket. Walker's got 13 points here in the second half alone.
That's why Walker is out here. I mean, he's got the ability to capitalize in big spots of the game.
Paul with a wide-open look, and it's off from three-point range. Three-pointer, Hayward. Basket number five goes in. He's now 5 of 12 from the floor. Pelicans trail by four. Outside Holiday. He kicks it to Ball. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. Holiday's got his fifth assist in this one. Walker in the post. He's covered by Ball.
And he's been a force on the glass all game long.
Yeah, I love the way he's fighting through box outs, using his elbows. I mean, he's doing whatever it takes.
This is the challenge Williamson possesses to many defenders. Hard to guard him without fouling.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. And he ends up missing both free throws. Boston's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway.
He's so clutch, Kevin. When the pressure is at its highest, that's when he's at his very best.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans. They're behind by four. There's 53 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. There's 53 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Brown against Holiday. Here's Williamson. Money!
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
Well, that was 1-2. He wanted the ball. Nobody else was taking that shot.
I think we'll see them burn the clock a bit here.
Yeah, smart move.
Here's Walker. Pass to Tice. And stolen by Favors.
This isn't a done deal yet, but they have got to move quick.
They've got to go all out trying to force a turnover here.
Look at this young man come through in the clutch. Zion appearing more than ready to deliver.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Tucker against Ball. Outside, Walker. From deep, bullseye.
There isn't anybody they trust more than Walker down the stretch. He's made so many big shots over the course of his career. Add another one to the list.
And so timeout taken by Alvin Gentry. Guys, your thoughts?
And they need a miracle, guys. They don't have enough time for the catch and shoot three, so the only hope is for an alley-oop and an and-one to finish out.
And so it's Boston scraping by with the win. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Gordon, a great win over a very explosive team tonight.
Yeah, they're a team, you got to be physical with them. You know, you can't let them get a rhythm going with the scores and the talent that they have. So we had to really match their intensity, and I thought it was a great win.
I know that's what you guys work on extensively in the show tonight. Thanks, Gordon. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. So long.